You got to buy something you don't really want.
It certainly is. It certainly is. With that said, speaking of changing teams, Antonio Brown last weekend was spotted working out with, and not even spotted, he posted it on his Instagram page. It became a huge thing on TMZ, everything else. He is working out with the Seattle Seahawks. He has been running routes with Geno Smith. He's been running routes with Russell Wilson. And he posted and said, who would like to see this fall? Give me your thoughts here. I don't really know what to make of this. I think he's going to get suspended, you know, a certain number of games or whatever, but maybe not the whole season. And the Seahawks do have a need.
And you want him at the back end. You don't care about the first 4 weeks. Okay.
But is it only four? I mean, it could be eight. Like, even if it's half the year. Yeah,
let him take any type of suspension.
Oh, we're losing Chris here.
Whatever it is, and it probably won't.
We are losing Chris.
Still with me?
Yeah, I got you here.
You still with me?
Yeah, I got you. Right,
sorry about that. All of a sudden, literally, I just had a blip that said unstable internet real quick.
It's all good. It's all good. We got you.
It won't be 16. It won't be 12, okay? So yeah. All you need is for him to have four or five games under his belt to get his wheels back and
in time
and
for the playoffs.
Be able to work with the team and in the playoffs. That's what you want him for anyway. Then nobody has any game film on him or how you're going to use him a whole lot. Going into the playoffs, they can make a hell of a run.
Yeah, I mean, the two guys that they've really got are Lockett and Metcalf. You toss in Brown with that bunch, and
yes.
And all of a sudden, Russell Wilson is dangerous.
Lockett is all about speed, and those guys fall off fast.
Yeah.
Last year, towards the end of the year, Lockett was starting to get caught a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
And it could have been fatigue. It could have been minor injuries that weren't big enough to be on an injury report, but just struggling with, you know, this is what 16 weeks of football will do to you kind of thing. If he's on the downward at all, they got DeCap and nobody else, because the way Lockett plays football is if he loses his speed, we see those receivers come and go all the time. They'll be dominant, jobless.
Yeah. Now you're dead on.
And I was worried about that last year. I love watching Lockett play. That guy, when he is on, he is lightning.
Ben jumped in on Twitch, said Metcalf and AB, yikes. And then Damien.
That's scary as hell.
Oh, yes. Damien said whoever signs AB better still have that special gear he wants.
I'll tell you this. I think Pete Carroll's the perfect coach for him. I really do.
I mean, think about what he did.
If Pete can't get with him and deal with him, nobody in the league can.
No, you're 100% right.
D-O-N-E, done, if Pete can't do it.
No, you're.
There's not a more player friendly coach in the business.
No, he would be the perfect landing spot for him.
And I think Russell's a strong enough leader and has control of that locker room well enough to kind of keep AB in check.
No, I think you're right about that. I mean, you're dead on. I'm looking to see if there is anything else that has popped up. Have you seen anything?
No, I mean, just a bunch of baseball scheduling stuff coming out, and that we're just going to see that rolling through over time.
Ian Rappaport gave out a different number than – did you see this?
I don't know what you're talking about.
The Mahomes deal. Ian Rappaport came out 28 minutes ago and said, the Chiefs and quarterback Patrick Mahomes have agreed to terms on a 10-year extension worth $503 million. He gets $477 million in guarantee mechanisms and gives the ability for Mahomes to have outs if the guarantee mechanisms are not exercised. There is a no trade clause.
So that's different. That's
insane. That's different than Chuck.
When we get the headline deals, those are all speculation until we get details.
Yeah.
And I want to see how much is front-loaded, how much is back-loaded. Because there are smart ways of doing these deals, and there are dumb ways of doing the deals. Manny Dalton way was a smart way. All they had to do was not pay him for 2019 and cut him and go find some other chump quarterback to tank with, which is what they did anyway. Why did you pay $16 million to Andy? Save that $16 million. And then you have other teams that do things that are so outside the box, something I've never seen or heard of before in the 49ers. They went, they traded for Jimmy G. When they gave Jimmy G their extension, Jesus, the Mississippi came out of that.
Yeah.
when they gave Jimmy G his extension, they had $45 million of free cap money that year that they had to spend. They had to spend it. So they front load it instead of back load it. And he got like 30% of his 5-year extension in his first year. That means year 2, 3, 4, and 5, they're getting him on the crazy cheap.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so there are ways of looking at these deals. It all, you just never want to look at a deal and say, this is the deal. It's never, you know, 10 years, $500 million. Oh, it's $50 million or whatever. It's never that. It's never that.
No, you're right.
The detail is everything. We'll know who's right and who's wrong. I'll tell you this. This might be blasphemy growing up and just following ESPN my entire life and Adam Schefter being what he's been in my life for as long as he has. I would trust Ian's reporting over Adam's reporting.
I agree with you 100%.
Ian has proven that he doesn't care if he's the first. He'd rather be the right.
Yeah.
And coming out basically 2 hours after the report.
Coming out with the actual details.
But having a right number shows he's really good at his job.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I agree. So close out with these two, by the way. Joseph Gomez said, just a matter of AB wants to play for the coach. Make sure you keep him away from the cryo chamber. And Damon said, wait, doesn't it snow in Seattle? Better hope he doesn't get frostbite. Yeah. Yeah, just ridiculous. We'll close out with this. Rest in peace, Charlie Daniels. It's another one lost. We've lost a bunch of them through this whole thing. This was not COVID-related. This was
he had a stroke. I mean, yeah. You live the way Charlie lived. The fact that he made it this long.
83 years, man. So, Devil went down to Georgia, a whole bunch of other stuff. I saw Charlie Daniels multiple times.
I'm
going to
tell you this.
Yeah.
Not what we want to tell kids, but him and, like, Keith Richards and folks like that, listen, we might have been lied to about the dangers of drugs growing up.
We ain't even going to tackle that today. But you're right. You're dead on. You are dead on.
How the hell do you explain these folks?
It doesn't make any sense at all. It makes no sense.
I'm just playing. Don't do drugs. They're bad. I'm just kidding.
Rest in peace, Charlie. You will be missed. Hell of a showman. Hell of a songwriter. Fantastic fiddle player. Fantastic. I mean, just unbelievable guy. Unbelievable guy. With that said, that's going to wrap up the show. Of course, go to winningcureseverything.com. Make sure you subscribe everywhere that you need to subscribe, whether it be on the live show or on the podcast. If you're doing it on the podcast, go to Apple Podcasts. Leave a nice review. You guys know what to do there. And go on over to sportsbookreview.com. Make sure you are subscribed to the YouTube page over there. That's where our college football content will be this fall. So make sure you don't miss anything. Starting on August 1st, that will be our first video over there. So make sure you know what's going on. All of that to say this, take care of yourself. Take care of each other. We will see you tomorrow.
Thanks for checking out Winning Cures Everything. If you want to keep up with us, hit subscribe on YouTube or your favorite podcast app. Visit the website at winningcureseverything.com, or you can like us on Facebook or follow us at Winning Cures, at Gary WCE, or at Chris B. Giannini on Twitter. Share out the show. Leave a nice